Hey everyone, in case you're unaware, AMD AM5 motherboards powered by the newly released B850 and B840 chipsets are now available for purchase on the market. For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a mainstream gaming motherboard that sports the mid-range AMD B850 chipset, the ASUS TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs, and the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and it'd be par for the course for new processors to be launched alongside new chipsets and new motherboards. For some reason, AMD chose to launch its new 800 series chipsets more than a month after the launch of its Ryzen 9000 CPUs, starting first with the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets back in end September 2024. Fast forward to January 2025, we now finally have AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets arriving on the scene in the form of the B850 and the B840. Now, the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the mid-range AMD B850 chipset and sits within the mainstream TUF Gaming series of motherboard offerings targeted at gamers, where it places below the ROG Crosshair and ROG Strix series of boards, and above the value-oriented Prime series of motherboard offerings by ASUS. In keeping with the design language of the TUF Gaming series of products, the B850-PLUS WIFI comes in a box sporting a black and grey colour scheme with a touch of yellow thrown in for contrast. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Opening up the box, we see that the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI comes with a Wi-Fi antenna right here. Let's set aside the board for the moment to see what other accessories ASUS has included with the board. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by two packs of M.2 drive rubber pads that add additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. We do also get a quick start guide right here. And this is accompanied by an ASUS Web Storage promotional offer leaflet. And to round things off, a sheet of TUF Gaming stickers. Onto the board itself, ASUS has gone for a black and silver colour scheme with small touches of yellow, and as you can see, a military-like aesthetic is the name of the game here, which is very much in line with the TUF Gaming brand identity. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has large black heat sinks all around. Fans of integrated RGB lighting effects for their motherboards will be pleased to note that the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI comes with an illuminated TUF Gaming motif that can be found along the long edge of the board. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and ASUS has included 14+2+1 power stages with 80 amp DR MOS power phases. The B850 has a single chipset design, and the said chipset sits beneath this passive heatsink right here that comes with the TUF Gaming motif emblazoned on it with a mirror chrome finish. For M.2 drive cooling, ASUS has got you covered with M.2 drive heat sinks for all three M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. Over on the rear of the board, we get some subtle TUF Gaming motifs, which are a nice touch, I suppose, in spite of the fact that most of these motifs would likely never see the light of day inside of a PC case. For memory support, the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI comes with 4 DDR5 slots that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 192GB of RAM and the DDR5 8000 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single-tapped design that ASUS calls QDIM. It also features AMD's Expo technology, which are basically built-in overclocking profiles for DDR5 memory. Near the RAM slots is a USB 10Gbps Type-C front panel header, as well as a USB 5Gbps front panel header, which provides support for up to two USB 5Gbps Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight: we get a serial port header for you folks out there with legacy devices that still use a serial port, a Thunderbolt 4 add-on card header, which is to be used in conjunction with a Thunderbolt 4 add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS, a clear CMOS header, as well as a chassis intrusion header. Moving on, we also get a set of QLEDs up top that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 X16 slot that sports the ASUS Safe Slot feature, which reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. A nice quality of life feature that ASUS has included with this board is PCIe slot queue release, which is a mechanism that facilitates the easy removal of a graphics card from the motherboard. We also get two PCIe 4.0 X1 slots and a full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. Do note that PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. In the storage department, ASUS has included four SATA 3 ports, with two ports in a right-angled configuration and two ports in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with a single PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot and two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots. Do note that these slots support NVMe SSDs only, and they do also come with the new M.2 Q-latch feature, which facilitates the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 SSDs. Again, do note that PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. You might want to note too that the third M.2 slot, M.2_3, shares bandwidth with the full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode, where the said PCIe 4.0 slot will be disabled when you have a M.2 SSD installed in slot M.2_3. For audio, ASUS has included a higher-end Realtek ALC 1220p audio codec. Wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet, while Wi-Fi is courtesy of MediaTek's MT7925B22M Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 160 MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with seven fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are three Gen 2 addressable RGB headers. Moving over to the rear I/O, the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI goes for an integrated I/O shield design, and it comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector that supports display output of up to 8K resolution at 30Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 3 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, a 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet port, 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a USB 20Gbps Type-C port, 4 USB 5Gbps Type-A ports, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Q antenna connectors, a BIOS flashback button that allows end users to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM or graphics card, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. To round things up, the ASUS TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI comes across as a well-balanced mainstream AMD B850 motherboard offering that comes with just the right amount of features that actually matter. We're talking a decent VRM setup that should handle even high-end AMD Ryzen 9000 series processors with ease. PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card and an M.2 drive, a relatively high-end audio codec, 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet and Wi-Fi 7 support, as well as a handful of nice quality of life features such as PCIe slot Q release. That said, one downside that I can think of is the fact that the included MediaTek Wi-Fi 7 module doesn't support the full 320MHz channel width that higher-end Wi-Fi 7 modules tend to support, which is a bit of a bummer. Nonetheless, given the features and specs of this board, I'd say that the TUF Gaming B850-PLUS WIFI is still a pretty solid mainstream AMD B850 motherboard offering. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.